So hello guys, welcome to another video. So today I'm gonna show you how to use MSI Afterburner to display FPS, temperature and stuff in your game, and just like I do in my games, and how to use it properly and how to display the overlay on the game. So without any further ado, let's start the video. So at first I'll show you the thing which I'm talking about. So I'll just go to my channel real quick, then let's open this video, the latest one. So as you can see, wait, let me just end the ad, then I'll show you. So as you can see on the upper left corner, there's temperature, CPU usage, GPU usage, GPU temperature, RAM usage, FPS. So yeah, how to do that? So first of all, you need to download this application and install it on your computer. So search for MSI Afterburner on Google or any other search engine. So after that, go to the first link. By the way, I'll provide this link in the description of the video, so don't worry, every important link will be in the description. So yeah, after going to the link, just scroll down, and when you see, like, just scroll down to the bottom of the page and download this one, click on the download button. Don't click on the beta download, like there's something, like some features will be more in this beta, but it's not stable, so it's better to download this one. So download and install it, and install the River Tuner also. So when you install MSI Afterburner, it will also ask you for the River Tuner installation. So the River Tuner helps to overlay the things on the game. So yeah, that's important. So after you've downloaded that, go to your desktop and open it, open the app, just like that. So this is the layout of the application. You can change the theme of this application, like what you need from the settings. So at first, go to settings, then make sure to enable these two options, start with Windows and start minimize. So whenever you will open your PC, it will just start with Windows and will be minimized in the taskbar. So yeah, it will help you, like if you launch a game, then it will automatically show you the FPS. So at first, in the general tab, select your GPU. I have only one GPU in my computer, so this is my GPU, RTX 2060. So you can copy those settings or like put it on default, these are not so important. So after that, go to the on-screen, like the monitoring tab section. After that, here you will see like many things, like CPU usage, temperature, etc. And just make sure you put them in correct order, like in which you want to show them, just like in my video. As you can see, like here is CPU, then GPU, then RAM and FPS. So just like that, I have put the CPU usage and temperature at the top, and then GPU usage and GPU temperature, then RAM and frame rate. So yeah, so how to enable them on the screen. So at first you need to click on like check it which you want to show them, and yeah, you can also drag them on top if you want to drag to make it more like easy to find. So after you have selected them, just click on any one, click on this box, show in on screen display. So yeah, click on that and do this for all those which you want to show on your game. So for me, it's only 6 that I show on my game. And then like here you can see on the override group name, you can change the name to whatever you want, like whatever you want to show on the game. So in default it will be CPU, like only CPU. Just like RAM, in default it will be only RAM. So if you want to add custom text, just like me, like I have 16 GB of RAM in my PC, so I just add 16 GB, just like that. So it will show 16 GB, just like this, as you can see. So yeah, click on apply. And for CPU also I've changed that. So for CPU I'll change that to Ryzen 5 2600X. So yeah, just a second. Yeah, so apply that and apply to the next one also. And for GPU, just like me, I use RTX 2060, so my GPU is RTX 2060. And for frame rate, the default will be D3D, like DirectX or something. If you are running a game on Vulkan, then it will show you Vulkan. So for me, I have changed it to FPS. So yeah, that's it for this tab. I think it made you clear. Like at first, click on this tick mark, then put them in the order, correct order. Then click on them and click on the show in on-screen display, and go to this override group name and say add a custom text if you want to add that. So after that, you have done everything in MSI Afterburner. You can just minimize it, don't close it, just minimize it. So then you go to the taskbar and open River Tuner. It will automatically open every time you open MSI Afterburner. So yeah, let's click on that. And here you can see the color of the counter and the size and everything. So just copy my settings, it will help you. Like at the default, it will get low, the application detection level. So make it to medium. Like some games, sometimes like this MSI Afterburner doesn't detect any games. So for that, I'll suggest you to keep it on high or medium. I keep it on medium and it works with every game. So yeah, that's it. Then these are not so important. Then go to on-screen display rendering mode. Put it to rest to 3D, yeah, that one. Then on-screen display coordinate, it's viewport, and on-screen display shadow, I put it on, like it looks cool on, but you can also put it to off, but the shadow will not be there. So it's like more visible with the shadow, so I put it on. So after that, on-screen display fill, I put it to off. Like if you put it to on, then it'll just, like it'll make it opaque. And if you put it off, then it will be transparent. And it's easier to show on the screen. And it doesn't like cover up anything on the game. So on-screen display zoom is the size of the overlay. Like I use the second one. It's the smallest and this is the second one. So yeah, I use that. And if you want to change the color, then just click on the palette and select the color. I use green as it is easier to see to your eyes. And this is the position of the overlay. You can put it all the way if you want to add a custom number, let's say 100. You can put it all the way to 100. And so I put it on 1 as I show it on the upper left corner of the screen. So yeah, that's it. So minimize that. So for example, like I'll open Valorant now and you guys can see like how it looks when I open the game. So let's open it. So the game has been started, and here you can see just like I have put the settings on the upper left corner and everything, it will show you. And yeah, the green color, I don't know why it's not working, but like the green is only coming to the RTX 2060. But when I used to use the laptop, like the MX150, here you could see the green color on the overlays also. So I don't know what happened to that. If you know, just comment down below. So yeah, that's it. You can see the CPU usage, temperature, the GPU usage, temperature, and RAM and FPS. So if you have any queries, like I'll show you once more. Go to the River Tuner. You can change the position whenever you want. Like it's 110. So as you can see, it has been shifted the place. So for like display fill, you can see it's like translucent, not opaque, it's translucent. So yeah, I'll just put it to my defaults, like 1, and display fill off. So yeah, so yeah, that's it for today guys. It's very easy to do and it will like just change in real time. And yeah, make sure to do this, make sure to put the MSI Afterburner like in startup. It will help you, and like sometimes you forget to turn it on, so it will just help you to display the FPS and stuff when you start the game. So yeah, that's it for today guys. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you have enjoyed, make sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you are new here. And yeah, so yes, here share it with your friends if you want to. It will really help them to display the FPS and stuff in with their games. And if they want to do benchmark videos, then it like also be helpful for them. So yeah, I'll catch you up guys later. Bye.